DBS is then performed if patient have selection criteria met or satisfied. After the procedure, after about 4 weeks, the DBS system is turned on. This is a brain pacemaker, and the pacemaker is positioned in the chest underneath the collarbone, and it is connected through wires passing through the neck to 2 electrodes that are positioned in a deep part of the brain, the basal ganglia. The basal ganglia are structures involved in dystonia generation, and usually they are targeted by DBS with a structure called GPI, Globus Pallidus Pars Interna. But also other structures of the brain can be used for DBS, especially for dystonic tremor. The thalamus can be used, and more rarely, the sympathetic nucleus can be used as well. So we said that the system is turned on after about 4 weeks. And the first turning on is called programming session. In that programming session, the neurologist probe different stimulation parameters and decide which is the best site of the stimulation and which is the best combination that determine less likely side effects. The side effect of the stimulation can be due to the spreading of the electricity to the structures that are around the globus pallidus part interna. So people with dystonia, because of too much electricity, they can develop difficulty to speak, difficulty to move because of involuntary contraction that are, in this case, masked or induced by the stimulation. So for this reason, it's very important to define the best side of the stimulation, because we don't want this side effect to occur. Also, we shouldn't forget about side effect and potential side effect induced by the surgical act itself. Surgery must be safely conducted, but sometimes very harmful side effect may occur, such as bleeding or infection. The bleeding, it occurs in the brain in less than 2% of the case, and it leads to disability very rarely, but still is a very harmful condition and should be remembered. And this is the reason why we want to select the best candidates, because having lesion in the brain is a risk factor for this bleeding. Also, infection of the system might occur. This can happen immediately after the surgery or even after years. Deep brain stimulation is a neuromodulation technique and is reversible, meaning that the effect of the procedure can be stopped in case of severe side effect or like not enough benefit for the procedure. We were rarely asked from the patient to stop the procedure. This is feasible to do. This is different from other types of surgeries like that were performed many years ago, like pallidotomy. About 30 years ago, pallidotomy was used to manage dystonia. So this neurosurgical technique involved the same rationale of deep brain stimulation, but a lesion was involved. So people with dystonia were receiving a lesion in their GPI. This means that the procedure was not reversible and was involving a little stroke in the GPI. With deep brain stimulation, it's possible to shape different parameters, and we can fine-tuning according to the evolution of dystonia and also to the change of dystonia over the months and year. This is a unique opportunity. We have been follow-up people that have received DBS for dystonia also for 10 years and still being able to shape their dystonia with this modulation of the brain. So people with DBS and dystonia, they can travel, they can use their phone. I've been asked many times about this question, but they should adopt particular precaution regarding having this pacemaker. These are the same issues that apply to people with cardiac pacemaker. With the novel device, they can also undergo brain MRI and they can undergo MRI under particular safety condition. So the pacemaker can be set in a particular safety mode, but most of the pacemaker used for DBS are currently compatible with MRI machine. People with deep brain stimulation, they can live a normal life. Indeed, they can have access finally to traveling and leisure activities. Obviously, there are some restrictions, or I would say precaution, to take in order not to damage the system. Obviously, I'm not suggest to undergo very dangerous sports or engage in bungee jumping, but most of the sports are allowed. We need to protect the wires from traumas, and this is the first precaution. But still, people is able to use their phone, to go in shops, to go to the banks, and even to travel, just showing the pacemaker card to people that is managing security. Technology in the DBS field has advanced very much. Now we have a smaller pacemaker. We have a rechargeable device whose batteries may last even for 25 years. And also those new device allows the clinician to use such a wide range of combination of parameters and has improved the care and the outcome of people with dystonia treated with deep brain stimulation. And this advance occurred in the past 5 years. And we are very confident that technological advance will further improve the care of dystonic people with deep brain stimulation.